Hello and welcome back. My name is Dr. Cheryl Lentz, owner of the Refractive Thinker Press. Today our focus for tips for postgraduate writing is on the scope and limitations as offered in Chapter 1 and reviewed again in Chapter 5 in the graduate thesis format or for most doctoral dissertations. Scope and limitations are very important to the nature of your study. As your study begins with your problem statement and purpose statement, this outlines the reason and direction for your study must also indicate its limitations. In addition to what your study intends to accomplish, a discussion of what your study intends not to accomplish is of importance and value as well. What are the boundaries that perhaps the design of your study may not allow? This could include sampling. Is your sampling a non-probability or purposeful sampling, for example? Why? Perhaps it was not cost-effective to survey all members of the organization. Perhaps it was not time-efficient to survey all members of the organization. Perhaps there's a limitation in efficiency in the scope and validity of your survey instrument. Perhaps there are limitations to your choice of methodology. For example, the Delphi technique, the literature review as offered by my dissertation, offered four primary limitations to the use of the standard Delphi technique as offered by authors Nekolachuk, Fansinger, and Lawler. As a result of these limitations, great care was taken with the ability to generalize the result and findings when I discussed them in Chapter 5. Remember, there is often confusion by what is meant by delimitations, which are characteristics and details about your study that may limit the scope or define your specific boundaries of your study. Just by defining your problem statement in any particular way, you are potentially limiting the boundary and scope and parameters for your study. There are many approaches you could consider. By taking your particular approach, you're committing to a particular scope of action and path that you'll be traveling. You will need to clearly define what you intend to study as well as what you do not. Be very specific in both areas for your reader to clearly understand your intentions on both levels. Limitations, by contrast, are what elements will affect the ability for your study to generalize the results. What conclusions will you be able to draw from your study within your specific boundaries? Let's consider your sample population, for example. Is your sample size large enough? Remember that Cresswell indicated that approximately 30 participants for a correlational study that relates variables would be acceptable as an appropriate sample size. Anything less, and this could potentially limit the validity of your study to expand much beyond its initial population sample. Remember, our goal with our study is what can our study add to the general body of knowledge at its conclusion? What we'll be able to offer with our study is a result of our various choices with regard to the consideration of your study's problem statement, purpose statement, methodology, sample size, and population. Please be sure to spend some time and thought with regard to those areas. Let me once again invite you to find at least three sample studies from a prospective university that mirrors your study for you to closely follow its logic, format, and overall organization, presentation, subheadings, and perhaps even design. The sample studies will offer delimitations and limitations for your study to consider further. For more tips on effective postgraduate writing to include both videos and transcripts, please visit my blog at www.refractivethinker.com/WordPress. Thank you again for joining me. My name is Dr. Cheryl Lentz. I've enjoyed our time together, and I hope you find these suggestions for crafting an effective doctoral dissertation or graduate thesis within this video helpful. Much continued success to you and luck as your academic and professional journeys continue. Bye now.